Hello everyone. In this video, we'll discuss Cauchy integral theorem, derivatives of analytic functions, and we'll solve some related problems. Okay, so let us go into the statement first. So it says if you take an analytic function fz in an open region R, okay, this is the open region R, there you take some function fz. Okay, so fz is the function which is analytic in this region R, and there you take a positively oriented rectifiable closed Jordan curve. What does it mean? This is a Jordan curve, this is a closed Jordan curve, okay, and it is positively oriented. That means it is in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so there if you take z0, a point which is situated within the curve gamma, that means interior of gamma over here, then we have such relation. Okay, so what does it say actually? So let us discuss what does it say, right? So if you take an analytic function fz, okay, so and you take some region R, so fz is analytic in this region R, okay, and there you take some closed curve gamma. Okay, so there you have a closed Jordan curve gamma, and you want to integrate this fz along this curve gamma. Okay, then what happens? The value is zero, isn't it? This comes from Cauchy-Goldstein theorem. Okay, so that is already discussed in my video regarding Cauchy-Goldstein. So that you can follow in my channel. Okay, so whenever you have a function fz which is analytic within an on gamma, closed Jordan curve gamma, then the value is always zero. Now what happens if you have some point situated over here z0, that means there is a point z0 where the function is not analytic, right? So in that case, you cannot apply Cauchy-Goldstein theorem, right? Because the condition is not true. Okay, so in that case, so what happens? So in that case, whenever z0 is situated over here, that means interior of gamma, so in that case, we can apply Cauchy integral theorem. So whenever fz is analytic within and on a closed curve gamma, we'll apply Cauchy-Goldstein theorem and the value would be always zero. And if we have some curve, closed curve gamma, okay, so this is our curve gamma, and in the interior of gamma over here, so z0 belongs to I gamma, interior of gamma, so there the function fz is not analytic, okay, and let fz, so fz can be say written as say, so you are integrating actually, say you are integrating a function gz, say, okay, so gz is not analytic within a non gamma, right? So there is a point z0 where the function is not analytic. Say this can be written as expressed as z minus z0. Okay, gz can be written as fz by gz, z minus z0, right? So you can see gz is not analytic at the point z0, right? So z0 is a point of singularity of the function gz. So in that case, how to evaluate this integral? Okay, so if gz is analytic within a non gamma, then it is zero, but if not so, there is a point z0 where the function is getting some singularity, okay, so and this can be written in this form, okay, then what happens? Then we can apply Cauchy integral theorem, okay, so to evaluate these kinds of integral, we have Cauchy integral theorem. Okay, so now let us go into the statement. You see, so gz can be written as fz by z minus z0, and there is a restriction about fz, right? So this part, the part on the numerator, the function is denoted by fz. Now this fz is analytic within a non-gamma, right? Okay, and z0 is any point inside this region, okay, then we have these kinds of expressions, okay, so then we can evaluate this integral from Cauchy integral formula as, so we have integral of fz dz by z minus z0 that is equal to over gamma that is equal to 2 pi I times f of z0, okay, so this is the formula we are going to use to evaluate these kinds of integral. Okay, so let us go into an example. Okay, so you see this function. So this is the function gz, right? So is it analytic within a non gamma? So what is our gamma, you see? So let us draw the gamma first. Okay, our required curve, the given curve. Okay, so this is the curve gamma. Okay, so which is positively oriented, rectifiable, closed Jordan curve. So which is a circle, isn't it? This is a circle with center 0 and radius 2. So this is the point 2 0. Okay, so this is the point minus of 2 0. This is the point 0 0. Okay, so this is our 2i, this is our minus of 2i point. Okay, so now what about the singularities of this function fz? So you see, so here z equal to 0 is a possible singularity, or z is equal to 8i. Okay, this is a possible plus minus 8i. This is a possible singularity. That means it is plus minus 2√2i. These are the possible singularities, right? Okay, so now you see only z equal to 0 is situated in I gamma, right? So only z equal to 0, that is z0 equal to 0, belongs to I gamma. Okay, so what is our fz here? So first our task is to identify our fz, right? Okay, that function that is analytic within and on gamma. So cos z by z square plus 8, okay, this is analytic within and on gamma, right? Okay, so there is only one singularity of this function which is situated inside gamma, right? So about other singularities of the given function, they are not lying inside our domain, inside the region I gamma, right? So our function fz can be taken as cos z by z square plus 8. Okay, so now let us apply Cauchy integral theorem. So by Cauchy integral theorem, what do you get? So fz by z minus z0, what is z minus z0? It is 0, right? Dz over gamma, that is equal to 2 pi I times f of z0. What is our z0? It is 0. Okay, so it is 2 pi I times, our fz is cos z by z square plus 8. So it is cos 0, okay, divided by 0 square plus 8. Okay, so we are getting cos 0 is 1. So we are getting 2 pi I by 8, that is pi I by 4. This is the answer, right? So next, let us go into the derivative of analytic functions. Okay, so here you see, if fz be analytic in an open region R, then fz possesses derivatives of all order in R. This is the most important point, or important thing about analytic function, because if you take some real valued function of real variables fx, okay, and if I say f dash exists, that means first order derivative of f exists. So it does not say anything or assures anything about the higher order derivatives of fx. You cannot say whether the second order derivative of this function exists or third order derivative of the function exists, right? But in complex analysis, so if you have this information that fz is analytic in an open region R, okay, so that means fz possesses derivatives of all order in R, right? So in this region R, so if fz is analytic in a region R, okay, so that means fnz exists for all n, okay. So what is fnz? That means fnz means nth order derivative, okay, nth order derivative of fz. Okay, so nth order derivative of fz also exists in this region R. Okay, so now how to evaluate nth order derivative of f at some point z0? Okay, this we can find using the extension of Cauchy integral theorem, okay, for nth order derivative. What does it say? You see, so if fz is analytic within and on a region R, and there you take a positively oriented rectifiable closed Jordan curve, right, then so fnz, so if fz is analytic, then fnz, the nth order derivative of z, okay, f at the point z0, can be evaluated from this relation, right? So it says n factorial by 2 pi I over gamma fz dz by z minus z0 power n plus 1. So using this thing, so we can also evaluate this kinds of integral, isn't it? Over gamma, so the integral of this form can also be evaluated. So z minus z0 power n plus 1, okay, so that is equal to, you can see it is 2 pi I by n factorial, okay, by n factorial into nth order derivative of z0. f at the point z0, right? So here if you have n plus 1, then it is 2 pi I by n factorial into f and z0. So let us take some examples. So here you can see it is z minus I power 2. Okay, so it is z minus I power 2. So this is of the second form of Cauchy integral formula, that is the derivative form of Cauchy integral formula. So f and z0. So here we can apply this formula, right? So let us try to apply. So before that, let us first draw the curve. Okay, so this is a circle with center 0 and radius 2. So this is the point 2, 0. So it is I, it is 2i, it is minus of I, it is minus of 2i, and this is minus of 2, 0. Okay, so here you can see. So what is our fz? So here our fz is z cube minus 2z plus 1. Okay, so this is the function which is analytic. Within and on gamma, right? Within and on gamma. Okay, so this is our curve gamma, positively oriented rectifiable closed Jordan curve gamma. Okay, so this is the function which is analytic within and on gamma. And what are the singularities of this function? I. So here z0 is equal to I, that belongs to interior of gamma, right? Okay, so you can see I is situated over here, so it is interior of gamma. So here we can evaluate this integral as, okay, z minus I whole square. That means I can write this as 1 plus 1 over gamma. So what is the value of n here? It is 1, right? You just compare with the standard form, it is z minus z0 power n plus 1, right? So 2 can be written as 1 plus 1 of dz. So what is it? It is equal to n factorial 2 pi I by n factorial into fn z0. So here n is 1. So n factorial by 2 pi I. So 1 by 2 pi I, right? So it is 2 pi I by 1. So it is 2 pi I by 1 into, if dashed at the point, evaluated at the point I, right? Okay. So what is our f dashed of z? Let us calculate f dashed of z. It is 3z square minus of 2. Okay, so what is f dashed of I? F dashed evaluated at I, it is 3i square minus of 2, so it is minus of 5. So we are getting minus of 5, 2 pi I times minus of 5, so it is minus of 10 pi I. Okay, so this is the value. So the next example, so let us take e power 2z by z plus 1 power 4, okay, dz, along some curve gamma, say gamma is mod z equal to 3. Okay, so here we have the radius is 3. Okay, so it is 3, 0, it is minus of 3, 0. Okay, so here the singularity, so what is our fz? You can see it is e power 2z, right? So e power 2z is analytic. So it is analytic within and on gamma. Okay, on gamma. So this is our gamma, right? Okay, so within and on gamma, fz is e power 2z, which is analytic. Now what about the singularity? Z is equal to minus of 1, right? So which is situated over here. Okay, so it is minus of 1, 0. It is minus of 2, 0. So minus of 1 belongs to interior of gamma. So we can apply the second form of Cauchy integral formula, that means the derivative form. So it is gamma e power 2z by z minus of minus of 1 over 3 plus 1 dz, right? So our n value is 3. So it is 2 pi I by 3 factorial into third order derivative of a evaluated at the point minus 1. So our third order derivative, so what is f dash of z? You see it is 2 e power 2z. What is f double dash z? It is 2 squared, that is 4 e power 2z. And triple dash of z is equal to 8 e power 2z. Okay, so our required answer is 2 pi I by 6 into 8 e power minus of 2. Okay, so what do you get over here? So it is 3. So it is 8 pi I by 3 into e power minus 2. So this is the answer. So next, let us consider another example. So suppose you have to integrate over gamma 3z square plus z 7z plus 1 divided by z plus 1. Okay, in the region the curve is mod z is equal to half, right? So here we can see, so here mod z is equal to half, right? So this is a circle with center 0 and radius half. Okay, half 0. Okay, so this is the point where, and what about the singularity of this function? Okay, so it is possible singularity is z equal to minus of 1, right? So this is minus of half 0 and here it is minus of 1 0. So here you can see, so minus of 1 is not belonging to interior of gamma or on gamma, right? So this is our gamma. So here we'll use Cauchy-Gurtsa theorem. Okay, so using Cauchy-Gurtsa theorem, we can say this is 0. Because there is, because fz, so this is our fz, fz is analytic within a non-gamma, so it is 0. Now suppose we are integrating the same, okay, by z plus 1, we are integrating the same along some c. So what is our c? Suppose mod z is equal to 2, okay, or say mod z is equal to 3 by 2, okay. So that means this is a circle with center 0 and radius 3 by 2, right? So here it is 3 by 2. So it is 3 by 2, 0. So what is the singularity over here? It is minus of 1. So minus of 1, 0 is situated over here and it is minus of 3 by 2, 0. Okay? So here in this case, so this is along C. So in this case, our fz is 3z square plus 7z plus 1, okay, which is analytic, within and on, so this is our gamma C, okay, within and on C, okay, and possible singularity z is equal to minus 1 belongs to interior of C, right? So by Cauchy integral formula, you can see, so this is equal to, by Cauchy integral formula, okay, so by Cauchy integral theorem, you can say integral over C 3z square plus 7z plus 1 divided by z plus 1 can be written as, so here we are getting 2 pi I into f of minus of 1. Okay, so where fz is equal to 3z square plus 7z plus 1. Okay, so it is 2 pi I times 3 minus 7 plus 1. Okay, so this is minus of 6 pi I. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay, thank you all.